report on ongoing events. As of last night, the Imperial government has declared martial law by order of Crown Prince Cedric. A military command center has been established, and Governor General Rufus has been appointed as its interim representative. Further, as of this morning, railway access has been severely restricted, not only in Heimdall, but throughout all of Erebonia.
Extra, extra. His Majesty has been shot by a military student with an unknown background. Is this sabotage from a foreign country? Was it one of those Thor students? A foreign country? It could only be.
Resource at our disposal to determine the suspect's background. We will share this information with all of you the moment we are certain, so I ask that you wait for now, and above all, stay strong. I understand your anger, your sorrow, and your fear, and feel them just as keenly, if not more. And so I pledge to you, we will uncover the truth of this incident.
This is the morning news broadcast for Trista. We're told the Emperor's current status is still critical. At this point, it's hard to determine whether or not he'll be able to recover. We now have a message from Prince Olivert to share with you.
The Emperor has yet to regain consciousness. We cannot yet let our guards down. Do not become lost in rumors and hearsay. Remain steadfast, and support one another through this dark time. Have faith that the light of hope will yet show itself and illuminate the path ahead.
How awful. I hear the Empress and Princess Alphen are still unconscious. Oh, Adios, please guide us.
I never thought Ash would...
We had our differences at first, but he wasn't a bad person. After everything we overcame together, we grew to understand each other. And I know now, there is absolutely no way he's the kind of person who would commit such an atrocity.
I agree. He was definitely a troublemaking punk. But he wasn't selfish or irresponsible. And despite his lone wolf tough guy act, he'd always help us when we needed him. But looking back, something may have been a little off about him.
It was quite the surprise to hear he was from Hommel. Tita, you knew someone else who was born there, right?
Yeah, I didn't know there was another survivor. He's in Liberal right now. I'd like to contact him if possible.
Unfortunately, we can't use the communication network, and we're not allowed to board Panzer Soldats. To be honest, I'm beginning to worry about Altina, too.
Yeah. Maybe we should have stopped her from going.
Rain?
Never thought that kid could have done something like that.
It's my fault. Even though he seemed like he was tough, I always knew he was a bit unstable too. I should have done something about it after our trip to Hommel. But I kept getting sidetracked by other problems. I failed him as his instructor.
That's not true, Rin. This is my first time being an instructor, and I'm still a total half-ass. Toh is new here too. You can't just expect to be perfect at it after only a few months.
That's right, Rin. I think the important thing is what you do next. Altina's already hard at work, right?
Well...
I received a message through the emergency channel. We've been called to gather. I must report to Intelligence Division HQ.
But...
Are you going to be okay? Right now, things are...
There is no need to worry. I'm sure Milliam and Major Arendelle will be there as well. However, I'm more worried about Ash.
Well...
What he did was so out of the blue, there must be something going on behind the scenes.
And that black haze... I bet it had something to do with it!
That's the only conclusion I can come to.
It's possible he was being controlled by some manner of chemical or hypnosis. It is also fairly likely something of a magical nature was involved as well. Therefore, I will attempt to gain as much information as possible. I refuse to leave a fellow member of Class 7 behind.
Allie...
You've grown a lot.
I agree. She's become very dependable.
Even if you've been summoned, don't forget, you're still a student of Thor's. If they try to limit your actions, let us know through the emergency comm network. I'll come get you, even if I need to use Valimar to do it.
Instructor Rin.
Yeah, us too. We'll definitely come help you.
No matter what.
Please be careful.
Thank you, everyone. I will do my best not to cause you trouble.
You're right. I can't afford to fall behind the students. The principal and all the elders are doing everything they can too. Seems like the principal went to the authorities and Michael went to the RMP headquarters. I hope they've made some progress. Oh. Rin, could it be? Yeah, it's someone from the old Class 7. Oh, Milliam.
Rin, is Tilly there?
No, she got an urgent call from the Intelligence Division 2 hours ago. But you didn't?
Nope, not me. Lecter's busy with something too. So that means I'm too late.
Too late? What's going on?
Oh no, it's nothing. I'll take care of it, so don't worry.
Hey, Milliam! Altina. Milliam, so she can't get a hold of Altina either? I thought the princess' little trick would let us connect anywhere. Yeah, but it's not working. It seems I kept you waiting. My apologies for being late. Principal, Major Michael. Well, any news? Carbide's still in a coma and is in the custody of the Railway Military Police. Regarding the utter nonsense about him being a spy for the Republic, I have requested the authorities rescind their statement, but they're refusing. No. Although there's no question a crime was committed, we must ascertain his motive, background, and any abnormal symptoms. If by chance he was being controlled, we must determine the true culprit. I guarantee his safety until all the details are known. Major. Thank you. Yeah, thanks. I don't need your gratitude. He was one of my students too. Anyway, aside from Carbide, it seems things are becoming even more dire. Huh? I need you to gather all students in Car 3. The government will make an important announcement and we've been instructed to listen to it. This brings me back to right before the Civil War began. Oh yeah, when the Blood and Iron Chancellor was shot.
We cannot, we must not, and we will not. With blood and with iron, we shall mete out justice. Well played. Armbrust.
What's the security like this time? All buildings within a 3,000 arch radius are on full alert. There are security airships patrolling the area too.
Dearest people of Heimdall, and all citizens of Erebonia, I am Cedric Ryse Arnor, son of Emperor Eugent.
The Emperor yet remains in critical condition. Needless to say, we have the most skilled doctors available to attend to him. But the situation is still dire. We would greatly appreciate if everyone would pray for Adios to see him through this. However, this incident demonstrates without a shadow of a doubt the scope of the threat looming over our nation, and the identity of the foreign power that orchestrated this tragedy. In my father's stead, as Crown Prince, I hereby entrust the fate of our nation to a man I'm sure you may all be familiar with, Chancellor Gilliath Osborne. Alongside him will be Governor General Rufus Alberea, who has already proven himself instrumental in overseeing the military command center.
I am Rufus Alberea, interim representative during this period of martial law. We are still in the process of investigating the events that occurred at Valflame Palace. However, we have identified the weapon that was used. It was a handgun manufactured in the Republic of Calvard. It was a Verne Company make. It was made of a material that allowed it to pass through metal detectors without being discovered. Further, it has come to light that in the past few days, nearly 100 Calvardian spies had infiltrated Heimdall.
I am Gilliath Osborne, Chancellor of the Empire of Erebonia. It pains me beyond description that we can do nothing more for His Majesty than simply pray he pulls through. My inability to prevent this tragedy leaves me shaking with shame and regret. But I ask you, is this the time to cower in our homes? To sit and wait and worry? No, it is most emphatically not. After countless instances of military activity at our borders, our neighbor has finally become brazen enough to send spies into our capital. And now this. The message they have sent us is clear. For hundreds of years now, they have been a menace to our nation. But this is no less than a declaration of war. We can no longer ignore the threat at our eastern borders. The Republic of Calvard.
Needless to say, we would be foolish to take such a country lightly. Their size and military might are nearly equal to our own. Therefore, in order to survive, we must make a decision.
We must put aside the difference between noble and commoner, between individuals and organizations. In order to overcome this dire threat to our way of life, every citizen of Erebonia must come together as one. To enable such a feat, we will establish a new law in the coming days. It shall be known as the National Mobilization Law!
National Mobilization Law? The heck's that about? It sounds pretty scary. It's a political science term. We learned it in Instructor Toad's class, remember? Yes, a way by which the government can leverage absolute power over its citizens to prepare the entire country for war. It gives the government full control over people, businesses, groups, even entire provinces. Then that means... Political scientists have been debating over whether or not a crisis like this would ever actually happen. Now that it has, it will be used to justify things like confiscation of property and drafting. Are you serious? An ideal environment for a dictator. But a nightmare for the people, though there are a few ways for the government to sugarcoat it so they don't even notice. So that's what they meant. The surface and what lies beneath intertwining, just like His Majesty and the Chancellor said. Rin? So everything's starting to connect. Wait, then that means Ash was a convenient pawn. Or a prepared sacrifice? Either way, it seems some giant wheels have been set in motion, the likes of which we can't even imagine. This is all simply speculation.
Emma, Gaius.
Rin, are you at camp?
We need to meet up and talk about everything that's happening, including that speech just now. Also, there are some people you need to meet.
I have no issue with it. How about you?
Very well. We'd like to know the situation ourselves. But how do we leave the camp?
Good point. I don't think the Imperial Defense Force is just gonna let us waltz out of here.
Right, but we need to find an excuse so they'll let Rin out.
Oh, I'm sure we'll figure something out.
Celine!
What?
Is that Class 7's...
Ah, so the familiar's here.
Shut up and follow me! Get moving already!
Follow you where?
Do you recall that old oak tree in the center of camp? I'll summon a magic circle by it that will let you travel through the spirit veins.
You can do that?
Man, this magic stuff sure is handy.
Take us with you!
You guys!
Hey, all of you. Don't try to claim this doesn't concern us. Ash is our classmate.
We're worried about Altina too, so please let us go with you.
Come to think of it, this totally falls under our special ops missions, right?
All right. Class 7, resume special ops missions.
Yes, sir!
I don't care which of you tags along, let's just go already.
I need all of you to be careful.
If things get dangerous, give us a call.
If you're going to go, at least make sure you're fully prepared.
May Adios watch over you. Take care.
Oh, final chapter, For Whom the Bell Tolls. And here I thought the previous chapter was the last chapter, but okay. Well, near end game, finally. There, that old tree. We're gonna use this to teleport? This will be my first time traveling via magic. Before we leave, we need to check all of our equipment. Alright, once we're ready, we'll head to the old tree. Alright, well, if anything, guys, this seems like a pretty good stopping point. We are currently, and at long last, at the final chapter of this game, the last leg, and if anything, we'll continue on and finish this up in the next video to come. So, thank you again, and I'll see you all in the next one.